Bonsaipiece Theater. I'm Ofer Grunwald. I'm the director of Bonsai activities and the curator of the Bonsai collection here at the Jerusalem Botanical Gardens in Israel. And earlier this year, the Botanical Gardens decided that they want to renovate or reinvent their Bonsai collection, and that's where sort of I came into the picture. And as time went by and we were sort of working on the trees, sort of working on this project, I just noticed that, you know, it was just so fascinatingly intricate and complex and interesting, because it was really sort of taking, you know, really fundamental work, really interesting, really thorough work across the board of the entire Bonsai experience, you know, right from really the horticultural basics of maintaining the trees, maintaining their health, building their health, getting them ready to support us as we're restyling them, and all the way to the artistic aspects of the restyling, reinventing these old, you know, decades-old materials that were sometimes really very challenging to work with. And that's what this book blog is all about. I'd like to share my adventures on this collection with you, and all the work that we're doing, because I just find it so absolutely amazingly educational for me, and, you know, just coping or working with this challenge presented by this collection. So what I'd like to do this time, you know, we'll go and I'll show you a bit the display area, show you a bit the trees, sort of get you familiar with the Bonsai collection here, what we've got to work with, what the challenge is, and as we'll progress with this blog, I'll just be posting either videos or pictures of the work that we're doing, and hopefully you'll join me along on my adventure with the Jerusalem Botanical Gardens Bonsai Collection. All right, so here we are at the Jerusalem Botanical Gardens Bonsai Display Area, or the Bonsai section. As you can see, not much to see here. Now, the reason for that, as I told you, the Jerusalem Botanical Gardens were completely sort of reinventing and renovating the Bonsai collection. Now, part of that is, as I said, you know, reworking the trees, reinventing the trees, restyling the trees. But it's also being accompanied by this really, really big renovation project for the display area, which is going to be really, really nice. I mean, instead of this, you can see it was sort of like a cordoned off display where you couldn't really see the trees, and, you know, the ones that were further in, there was, you know, they just got lost. So instead of this old display, what they're actually building now is sort of like this really nice path that's going to be winding through the Bonsai display area with these really nice display stands or benches going along both sides of that path, and the path's going to be winding around like through the oaks and the cherries. There's actually Japanese cherry trees, and that's going to be winding up into a central plaza. From that plaza, it's actually going to be continuing and winding through the Bonsai workshop or work area, which is a really nice concept where, if you think about it, where visitors to the Jerusalem Botanical Gardens will actually be able to pass through the Bonsai display when then sort of interact with the artists and the people that are coming and working on the Jerusalem Botanical Gardens Bonsai trees, on the collection. And that's going to be a really, really sort of nice interaction. So that's, again, this is in the works at the moment. Estimated about 2-3 months from now, we'll be able to show you the really sort of nice display area that's going to be right here with, you know, the new trees. So enough about this, let's go see the trees. So here we are at the storage greenhouse where the trees from the Jerusalem Botanical Gardens Bonsai collection are currently being stored. A few words of background about the collection. So these trees were actually donated to the Botanical Gardens by sort of like the founding fathers of Israeli Bonsai, which the esteemed and honorable Mr. Chaim Shir and the late Rafael Shemi. So again, we have here actually about 300 plus trees. You'll see right now because they're in a storage shed, they're sort of all over the place, they're jumbled. You know, it's not a good display, but it's not supposed to be. It's a storage shed. Well, they're doing renovation downstairs. So again, these trees were donated by sort of the founding fathers of Israeli bonsai. They've been in the botanical gardens for quite a while now. Some of these trees have been, you know, taken care of and grown as bonsai for 30, 40 years. So, you know, they all have this really, really nice story behind them. And I'll show you because, you know, you'll go in and immediately you'll be able to see sort of like the challenges that we're being faced with this collection, which it's actually really sort of fascinating in its complexity because there's so many different things that can be improved and can be worked. And, you know, since we're in bonsai and it's always in bonsai, one thing is sort of interlaced with all the others. So if, let's say, we want to restyle a tree, but it's not in good health, and it's not in good health because the roots are, you know, in pretty bad condition. So we'd want to work on the roots and improve the roots, but we can't do that because the old soil has been sort of, you know, become sort of like a rock, so we need to do it gradually and rebuild the root ball, but in order to do that, we still have to sort of work on the tree's health. So it's all these different sort of factors that are being worked on simultaneously, and for me it's such a fascinating challenge because it's sort of each tree has a unique history and still there's so much work to be done, really, really interesting work from all kinds of different directions, a lot of really sort of hardcore horticultural work, laying down the ground, you know, the groundwork and the foundations that will enable us to build and develop these trees into bonsai down the road. So, you know, enough chit-chat, let me show you the trees. So again, as I said, we have here quite a number of trees. The collection itself has upwards of 300 trees. And as you can see, they're sort of just jumbled here in storage, waiting for the work to be finished downstairs. The renovation, you can see some of them have been worked on recently, been restyled, like this particular juniper. I'll upload you know, the before and after pictures of it. You know, before we started working on it, it was sort of like a meter and a half in length, and we sort of cut it down, started working on it as a bonsai. So again, a lot of really, it's a really, really varied collection in terms of the species we have here. A lot of ficus, but you know, a lot of different species of ficus, a lot of different species from South Africa, a lot of junipers, some pines. So again, it's sort of like a, in a way you can really sort of see that it's worthy of being in a botanical gardens collection because it's, you know, so many different trees from so many different regions of the world, which I think is sort of unique, at least in as far as collections that I've seen. So again, these are the trees. As you can see, a lot of work to be done. You know, let me just give you an example of what I was showing you before. Let's go back to this juniper and look at the soil. This is really, really, really tough. I mean, this I think it's been building up in a really sort of super rich, super organic soil that's not been replaced properly for over 30 years. And a lot of the work we did, like for example with this particular tree, if I take it as an example, we put in a lot of work sort of building up the health of the tree before we could start to restyle it. The tree reacted very, very well, which is what enabled us to do this really sort of initial styling. And down the road, now we need to sort of completely rebuild the root ball into proper soil. So again, you can see how the horticultural aspects, the soil, the structure, the roots, but the root ball is sort of interlaced here with the work on the styling. And again, so I'll be really happy to show you all the work on these trees, all the various aspects of it. And as I said, it's a very, very interesting, you know, work. Very, very varied, very, very challenging. And I'm happy to have you along for the journey. So stay tuned.